That's a biryani. That's banging in flavor. And that's when you hit the meat jackpot. When you get a piece of meat with a little bit of that fat.
ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾಟಿ ಟೊಮೆಟೊ, ನಾಟಿ ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಶುಂಠಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಪುದೀನ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಐಟಮ್ ನಾಟಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಗೀ.
That's that ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ, that ಆನಂದ ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ. Good morning, folks. This is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. When I said good morning, I must tell you it's bright and early in the morning. In fact, the sun is not out yet. It's just past 5 a.m. and we've been on the road for the last 15 minutes. We've set out to Hoskote, which is roughly about 40 kilometers from Bengaluru. And at Hoskote, they have the tradition of serving an early morning biryani. Now this is a biryani that's cooked through the night and they begin serving at 6 in the morning. That's right, at 6 in the morning, and they have customers lining up in queues to savor this biryani. So when I first heard of this Hoskote biryani tradition where customers line up early in the morning at 5-5:30 just to make sure they get the fix of biryani, I thought it was a bit too hyped. And then I saw some videos of people waiting in long lines. Now this biryani is not served every day of the week. It's served only on certain days. And they have customers by the hundreds and even thousands on Sundays. For those of you who follow Food Lovers TV and Gourmet on the Road, you know I like a good biryani. So this morning we've set out to savor some Hoskote biryani and see what the fuss is all about. Now in Hoskote there are multiple biryani outlets, and I'm told one of the most popular ones and perhaps also the earliest one is Anand Biryani, and that's where we are headed today. So stick around to taste some Hoskote biryani. Well, don't always trust Google Maps, because Google Maps brought us through some fields covered with slush. It's been raining here. In fact, quite a few moments where I thought the vehicle wouldn't make it. But somehow we are back on the national highway and we're 7 minutes away from Anand Biryani. Well, here we are at Anand Biryani. So that's Anand of Anandam Biryani. ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಿಲೋ ಇದೆ ಈಗ?
100 ಕಿಲೋ ಇದೆ.
100 ಕಿಲೋ. 100 ಕಿಲೋ ಕುರಿ. So there's 100 kilos of sheep meat in this. So this is a long grain rice that you see. So there's basmati and a variety called kesar kali. So 100 kilos meat ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇದು ರೈಸ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಾ?
80 kilos.
ಗುಡ್ ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಸರ್ ಸೌದೆ.
ಸೌದೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಮಾಮೂಲಿ ಸೌದೆ ಏನಾದರೂ?
ಹಾ, ಮಾಮೂಲಿ ಸೌದೆ.
So there's the mutton biryani, the special mutton biryani of Anandam Biryani that's happening here. ಏನೇನು ಹೋಗಿದೆ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ?
ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾಟಿ ಟೊಮೆಟೊ, ನಾಟಿ ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಶುಂಠಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಪುದೀನ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಐಟಮ್ ನಾಟಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಗೀ.
So even the ghee that he uses here is locally procured from the village around here. So he buys it from the farmers. So when you have good ingredients that go into the biryani, I suppose that's what you get.
ಇದು ಈರುಳ್ಳಿ, ಇದು ಈರುಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಾಮೂಲಿ ಈರುಳ್ಳಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾಟಿ ಈರುಳ್ಳಿ ಇದು.
ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಶ್ಯಾಲಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಲೋಕಲಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಶ್ಯಾಲಟ್ಸ್. ಇದು ಫಾರ್ಮ್,
ಇದು ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಇದು ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ, ಇದು ಇದು ನಾಟಿ ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ ಇದು.
ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ನಾಟಿ ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೈನಿಯ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಲೋವ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಪ್ಯಾಕ್ ದಟ್ ಫ್ಲೇವರ್ ಪಂಚ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ನಾಟಿ ಟೊಮೆಟೋ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೊಮೆಟೋಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲೆಮಿಷಸ್. ದೇ ವೋಂಟ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಟು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್.
ಫ್ಲೇವರ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ.
ದ ಲೋಕಲಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಟೊಮೆಟೋಸ್.
ಇದು ನಾಟಿ ಶುಂಠಿ ಸರ್.
ಇದು ನಾಟಿ ಶುಂಠಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಜಿಂಜರ್. This is a ginger that's supremely aromatic.
ನಾಟಿ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ ಸರ್.
ನಾಟಿ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ, ನಾಟಿ ಮಿಂಟ್.
ಇದು ಮಾಮೂಲಿ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇದು ಈ ಜನ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇದರ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು
ಘಮ ಘಮ ಇದೆ ಪರಿಮಳ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಕೊರಿಯಾಂಡರ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಅರೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೈಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್. ಸಮ್ ಫೆನೆಲ್, ಸಮ್ ಮರಾಠ್ ಮೊಗ್ಗು, ಸಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್, ದೇ ಕಾಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಕಲುವಾ ಹಿಯರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಅನೀಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ಕ್ಲೋವ್ಸ್, ಕಾರ್ಡಮಮ್, ನಟ್ಮೆಗ್, ಕ್ಯಾಸಿಯಾ. ಇದು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಲ್ಲ?
ಹಾಂ, ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿ. ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಪೌಡರ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್.
ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಪೌಡರ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ. It's not even 6 o'clock and there are already people waiting outside to savor that biryani. They begin bringing that biryani together at 3 o'clock. So you first have the ghee that goes in along with the spices, the onions and aroma banda mele, then you put the paste.
Yeah, sir.
So once the spices begin releasing the aromas, the essential oils, then he puts the paste of the tomatoes, the onions, the garlic and the ginger. And then the meat goes in with some more spices. And then when that meat masala is ready, then goes in some water. And then finally that rice. The rice which is a combination of the basmati, kesar, kalli. And then of course some coriander and mint that goes in the beginning and also in the end, where they sprinkle some of that over the biryani as it's being readied to be cooked on the dum.
ಈ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ ಪುದೀನ ಪೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಾಕ್ದಾಗ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ. ತುಂಬ ಜನ ಹಸಿಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕಿ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಬರೋ ಥರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಬಂದು ರೆಡ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ರೆಡ್ ಬರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ ಕೊಯ್ದಾಕ್ತೀವಿ, ಪೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ.
ಸೊ ದೇ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಕಲರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೌನಿಶ್ ರೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕಲರ್ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಮಿಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಕೊರಿಯಾಂಡರ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಕಲ್ಡ್ ಓವರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇನ್ ದ ರೈಸ್. Now they're removing all the wood, they'll only leave behind the embers. So he's compacted that rice, a little bit of water that's going around the sides, and now some more ghee.
2 kilo ghee.
100 kilo biryani, 2 kilo ghee.
Melgade hakodakke aduk munche 3 kilo hakirtivi.
Okay, so totally 5 kilos.
5 kilo.
So he's basically covering the biryani with banana leaves. He wants to make sure that while the biryani is cooking on dum, none of that aroma of the meat, of that masala, of the spices that's trapped in the biryani has an opportunity to escape. So the burning embers are now going on top of that biryani deg as it begins its final cooking on dum. I can feel the heat of that wooden embers. I can feel it in my eyes. So that fire that was at the bottom has already done its work and cooked that biryani. Now all that they want is the heat from the top for the biryani to cook on them. Well, the sun is out and so are the customers out here.
ನಂಗೆ ಅವಾಗ 14 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು ಸರ್.
14 ಇಯರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ 14 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು.
ಈಗ ನಂಗೆ 35 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಈಗ.
ಸೊ ಈಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 21 ಇಯರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇತ್ತು?
2 ಕೆಜಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ.
2 ಕಿಲೋ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ,
18 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
2 ಕಿಲೋ ಮೀಟ್.
ಹಾ, 2 ಕಿಲೋ ಮೀಟ್.
ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಫಾರ್ 18 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್.
18 ರುಪೀಸ್.
ಸೊ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಆ ತರ ಈಗ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಬಂತು ನಿಮಗೆ?
ಸರ್, ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನನು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಾನು ಚಿತ್ರಾನ್ನ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಬರೋ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಮಾಡಪ್ಪ, ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಒಂದು ವಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಡೆ ಒಂದ್ ದಿವಸ ಮಾಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಆಗ ಸಂಡೆ ಒಂದ್ ದಿವಸ ಮಾತ್ರ 2 ಕೆಜಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಅದೇನಾಗೋಯ್ತು, ಅದೇ ತರ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತು.
So from making chitrana idli, he is now rearing sheep that go into the biryani. That's quite a transformation. ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರೀ ಇದು 3 ಡೇಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಆ ತರ?
ಈಗ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಸಂಡೇ, ಟ್ಯೂಸ್ಡೇ, ಫ್ರೈಡೇ. ಆಗ ಜನ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ 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 ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು. ಅದು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ರೂಢಿ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು.
So he began first just on those 3 days and that's become now a tradition. So ಇದು ಕುರಿಗಳು
ಸರ್? ಇದು ಕುರಿಗಳು, ಇದು ನಾಟಿ ಕುರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ.
ನಾಟಿ ಕುರಿ ಕರೀತಾರೆ.
ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬರಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಮೀಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾಟಿ ಕುರಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ.
ಹಲಾಲ್ ಇದೆ,
ಹಲಾಲ್ ಹಲಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಹಲಾಲ್ ಇಲ್ದಿದ್ದು ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ನಾವು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿನೇ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು 22 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೂ ಹಲಾಲ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ.
ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ, ದೇ ಡೂ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಹಲಾಲ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. And the sheep, other male sheep, 15 kilos, 12 to 15 kilos is the weight of the sheep. ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ತರ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ? 6 o'clock ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಜನರು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ತಿನ್ನಕ್ಕೆ, 5 ಗಂಟೆಯಿಂದ ನಿಲ್ತಾರೆ ಹೊರಗೆ ಕಾರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ.
ಹೌದು ಸರ್.
ಯಾಕೆ?
ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆನಲ್ಲಿ, ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ, ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ.
ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹೊಸಕೋಟೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್. ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಟು ಎಮರ್ಜ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಮ್. ವಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 20 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್. When we came in, there were a couple of cars, a few people in there. But in the last 30 minutes that we've spent out here, we can definitely see that the crowd has increased. There are a multitude of cars around now. Big cars, small cars, motorcycles, and perhaps at least 100 people waiting to taste that biryani. You know, that explains for the popularity of the place. So that's Mrs. Anand, Rajni. So Rajni here makes sure that she collects the cash, gives the token, and Anand's mother there, Mrs. Ahalya, dispenses some of the other dishes in addition to the biryani. Chicken fry, amele kal soup ide. So new martira, maneli.
Ah.
7 o'clock now, and I'm told they'll run out by 9 a.m. sharp. So the biryani is cooked on dum, and we are now waiting for that reveal of that Anand biryani. Ah. I think this is a biryani where you smell more of the fresh masala that's gone in, as opposed to the aromats. Certainly is an aroma that definitely seduces you and makes you want to get a taste of that biryani. That's that Hoskote biryani, that Anand Hoskote biryani. So that's 180 kilos of the meat and the rice, and then the masale. So this is to total 200 kilos or better?
200 kilos.
And today is a Friday, so they're only cooking one deg. But if you come on a Sunday, how many degs are there? 3 degs.
Sunday, 5.
5 degs. So on a Sunday, they do 5 degs. As he's stirring that biryani, that the aromas of biryani are now gushing out to meet your nose. So the first share of the biryani always goes to the fire that feeds the biryani, that makes the biryani.
Drishti.
So it's also about taking the nazar out.
Nazar. Hey, token kada kada.
So eshtu rice, eshtu piece irutte?
Sir, 5 pieces irutte, rice ishtu.
What I like is that they serve it in these areca plates with that banana leaf. So no plastic. I think having watched the reveal of the biryani, can't wait to go out there and taste that Anand Hoskote biryani. Well, there's a long line of people waiting, but we're going to try and pay for a biryani. 2 biryanis and give me 1 kal soup, chicken fry. So we got our tokens now, we want to begin with our biryani. There's a line of customers waiting out there. And there I have my Anand biryani. Let's taste it now. Typically you get served in the areca plate with the banana leaf, but Mr. Anand here insists that I have to eat in this, off this banana leaf. There's also some paya here, some leg soup here, some kal soup and some chicken fry. But I think if I taste that, my biryani will cool down a bit. So I think I'm going to taste the biryani first, and hopefully somewhere along the line, taste the other two dishes as well. But it's a biryani that most people are here for, and that's what you see on the tables as well. So let's begin with that mutton biryani here. Taste the rice first just by itself. You can definitely smell the aroma of the masalas, and I think what you smell really is the aroma of the fresh masala, and also perhaps the unctuousness of some of the fat that goes into the making of this biryani. That's a biryani that's banging in flavor. You know, the flavors of the biryani are such that draw from the fresh masala that goes in, the ingredients that go in. So the nati belluli, the ginger, and those are the flavors that you predominantly taste. There is also the warmth that comes from the spicing, from the marat mugu, the kalua, the cloves, the cardamom, etc. But that plays a distinct second fiddle to the flavors of that fresh masala. This rice is supremely flavorful. I haven't even gotten to that meat yet. And every grain of rice is separate. You also have the aroma of some of that coriander, some of that mint. So I think the personality of the rice is driven largely by the fresh masala. And the spices, the hard spices, provide an element of aromatic warmth. Time now to taste some meat. They've been quite generous with the meat here. So I've got a few shanks. I've got about 4 or 5 pieces of meat. And with some of that fat. You need that fat in the meat to convey its flavors. The meat, though cooked well, certainly has a bit of a bite. This is a biryani that's probably as naughty as the ingredients that go into it. So I guess this is a biryani that you would expect to taste if you were in a village somewhere around Hoskote. So the meat is not the sort that will fall off the bone. It's a sort of meat that has a bit of a bite. And I think that's what people like around here. And sometimes you want your meat to have a bit of a bite laced with that charbi, with that fat. I also discovered some liver in there. That liver is soft. I love the flavor of mutton liver. Quite deep in its intensity. So this is a sort of biryani that calls for your involvement to pry the meat from the bone. I think that's what people enjoy here. The only noise that emanates is from the queue, the people waiting in the queue. But as for the people sitting and eating their biryani, they're eating it in complete peace and silence. So it really tells you that they're into their biryani. So Anand here has been a little more generous to me. Has just bought in some extra pieces of meat. When I go to an establishment, I expect to be treated like any other customer would be. Of course, with some provision being made for us to shoot well. But other than that, I really don't expect much from the establishment. Now this piece of meat is certainly soft and juicy. That's the sort of meat whose juicy succulence you bite into. I think there's also plenty of ghee that goes into this biryani. And it certainly is a biryani that's a filling one. So you taste the robustness of the masala, you taste the ghee, the fat of the meat, and it certainly fills you up. So the pieces out here are a mix. So there's some pieces which are a bit tough, which are the sort that you need to work on. And there's some that are extremely soft and juicy. So I guess they use a complete animal. So there's certain parts of the animal which are tender, and there's certain parts which probably have a little more connective tissue, and those are the pieces that are a little tougher. So it's a sort of biryani that keeps you happily engaged. Regular ayli eshu sathi bartira tingalige
3 times.
So shift mugsi biryani tindu manege hogi malagbeku iga. So they've just finished their shift at the factory, and on their way home, they've stopped by for a biryani. And I'm told they do it at least 3 or 4 times a month. It tells you the popularity of the place. I got a piece of meat now with some of the fat. And that's when you hit the meat jackpot. When you get a piece of meat with a little bit of that fat. There's also a bit of smokiness that you taste in the rice. I doubt I'll be able to get any of the marrow out because that marrow would have solidified. But not bad, we still got some out. When you have some marrow, you want to do your best to try and get some out of that bone. You get some, you don't get some. Now come to the last of my meat piece here. Also a sign that my biryani plate is coming to an end. But there's still plenty of rice on my plate. And truth be told, that rice is flavorful enough to be savored entirely on its own. So as it's cooked with that meat, all that masala on them, all the flavors of the meat, all the flavors of the spices, all the flavor of the masala rises up in that dish and impregnates the rice with its distinct flavor, and that's what you taste in every grain of the rice. This isn't a biryani that is khara, this isn't a biryani that's too spicy. This is a biryani that's flavorful. I think this is the earliest that I've ever eaten a biryani. It's not even 7:30 and I'm almost done with that mutton biryani. So let's taste a bit of that kal soup. All that coriander and definitely the smack of the gelatin in the lamb trotters. I can taste the gelatin and feel its smack on my lips. There is flavor, there is spicing, but it's quite mellow. It's not the sort that grabs hold of your throat. And I guess that kal soup has a tough act to follow, especially after tasting that mutton biryani. And speaking of tough acts to follow, there is also some chicken fry here that is made by Anand's mother, Mrs. Ahalya. And this is also a part of the menu here. As far as the biryani goes, there's only the mutton biryani here. They don't waste time with any other biryani. If you like your mutton biryani, then this is the place to come. If you are somebody who's particular about only tasting a chicken biryani, this is not the place for you. But then, if you don't mind, you have the chicken fry. Let's taste this. That certainly is a tasty chicken fry. This is the sort of chicken fry that somebody would cook for you at home. And I guess that's exactly what it is, cooked by Anand's mother in their home. So if you're running short of some of the meat, order the chicken fry and you can make your biryani go that much further. On that note, I'm going to go back to my biryani, that biryani rice. There's so much of rice in that, and of course with the meat, he's also served me one or two extra pieces. I'm literally groaning now. But he says there are people who love this biryani so much that when they come here, they eat three of them and go. And I guess if you're driving 40 kilometers to get here, spending a good 3 or 4 hours of your day early in the morning, I guess you make the most of it. You know, the other aspect of this biryani is that there's no green chili that's used. There's only some red chili powder that goes in, and that lends it a certain warmth along with the other hot spices that go into the making of this biryani. When you taste a biryani, or if somebody talks to you about a biryani, your first instinct is to ask them, what is a biryani like? Is it a Hyderabadi biryani? Is it a Kozhikode biryani? Is it a Vaniyambadi style biryani? An Ambur style biryani? A Donne biryani? Or perhaps something else? But I think what's interesting is that the popular biryanis, the good biryanis, have a character entirely unique of their own. And I think that's what the Anand biryani at Hoskote is all about. It's a biryani that's quite assertive in the masala that you taste. So basically the flavor of the nati garlic, the onions, the ginger, the shallots, maybe some of that coriander, the mint. And then you taste beneath that the delicate veil of some of the hot spices, whether it's the stone flour, the mace, the nutmeg, and many of the other aromatic spices that go into the making of this biryani. As far as the meat goes, some of the pieces are tender, the sort that are juicy, and there are some that you need to get involved with a bit to pry all that meat and the fat off the bone. But whatever said and done, this certainly is a biryani that's unique, made unique by Anand, who's been making this for the last 22 years. He began making this biryani when he was all of 16, making only 2 kilos of meat a day. And today, on a given Sunday, he makes 500 kilos of meat, along with probably about 400 kilos of rice. And looking around at the number of people who waited here diligently for an hour, for 2 hours, just to get a plate of the biryani, gives you an idea of its appeal. So I've enjoyed tasting this biryani, notwithstanding the fact that we had to wake up at an unearthly hour and drive for an hour and a half, wait here for about 45 minutes to an hour just to get a plate of the biryani. I hope you enjoyed this tasting of the Anand biryani at Hoskote. Until the next time, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!